Welcome to this video. In this video, you will learn all about the history and input fields in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Enjoy this video and let's get started. So here we are in the data browser and the transaction code SE16N. And in here, I would like to show and explain you all about history in input fields. So first of all, here we have an input field for the table. And there are two possibilities how you can call and use the history for input fields. The first one is with your space key on your keyboard. So now I push the space key on my keyboard, and then here a drop down list will open up, and there you can see the previously entered tables. For example, if you hover over one entry, then you will see this yellow background. And if you click on one previously entered input, then this input will be taken over once again and directly filled in this table field. So the second option is that you directly open up the history once you set the focus into this field. We will see later in the settings how you can set this up. And here we are seeing currently 20 entries in the history because I limited the maximum amount of history entries in the settings in the SAP GUI options. We can see later on. If you want to use the history in the command field, then you can't use just the space key on your keyboard. For this, you have to click on this dark triangle and the right side of this input field on this button. And once you've clicked on this, then you will see in here the history in the command field. And here you have a blue background of the entries, and the same as for the history in other input fields. When you click on one previously entered transaction code, then this will be taken over and you can reuse it once again. And now I would like to show you how you can delete specific entries in the history in the drop-down list so that you don't have to delete and erase the whole history file. And for this one, you have to open up the history. So in this case, with the space key on the keyboard, and then you have to hover over one entry that you would like to delete. And then you have to hit the delete key on your keyboard. So now I'm doing this for this entry, and then directly we can see that this entry is gone, has been deleted. I can also do it for other entries. So for example, if I scroll down for the TSTC, for this one, for this one, for this one, for this one, and so on. So this is how you can delete entries in the history. So this is really useful, especially if you would like to log in into the SAP system. And then you open up the SAP logon, double click on your connection. And for example, in user, you have typed in your password, hit enter by mistake. And then what we can see here that your password is in clear text in this input field. So there you can really easily delete this if you hit the delete key on your keyboard, and so you don't have to delete the whole history file. If we move back in here, then you have also the possibility to make some settings specifically for one input field. So to use and make changes to one input field, there you have to push the control key on your keyboard and then right click, and then this window opens up and here you see three options. So first of all, you can enable the history specifically for this input field, you can disable the history for this input field, or you can use the default settings that we will see in a couple of seconds. And this is quite useful that you can make some changes depending on the input field. And now you can make changes to the history in the SAP GUI options. So to access the SAP GUI options, first of all, you can click on this button, customize local layout. You could use the key combination Alt and F12, and then click on options. Or what you also can do is in the SAP logon in the top left corner, there you can click with your left mouse click and then choose options. And under local data and history, there you have settings for your history. So over here, you see the history status. You can turn off the history in general, you can turn it on, or you can set the option immediately. And what is the difference between on and immediately? So basically what I explained in a couple of seconds before, if you choose on, then you can call your history with your space key on your keyboard. If you choose immediately, then directly after you have set the focus into an input field, the history will be executed and shown. In the history settings, there you can make some settings for the history. So for example, when the history should be expired in a month. So in this case, after 3 months, the history will be expired. What is the maximum permitted file size in megabytes? What is the maximum number of entries? 20. And here, enable history for fields up to 255 characters. And over here, that is what I mentioned, because we just saw 20 entries in my history, because here I have set it to maximum 20 entries. If you want to, you can reduce it, you could increase it as you want to. In the enable history for fields up to characters, there normally, maybe for your case, there should be 59 in. And I would recommend to put 255 in there, because there are some input fields that allow 255 characters as an input. And if you just have 59 characters in the history, then if you maybe would enter 200 characters in such input fields, then the characters after the 59th character will be cut off and saved into history. So for those, you're losing data in the history, and because of that, I recommend to increase it to 255. With this button, clear history, then you can clear the history in total if you want to. And down here, you can see the directory for input history. If you make some changes and then click on apply and OK, then your changes are taken over and you can use it. So for our case, I would like to show you how you can directly immediately call the history. So I now choose the immediately option and then apply and OK. And in here, as you might have recognized, I directly set the focus into this input field and the history shows. And again, I'm moving out of this, for example, in here, and you are seeing again the history. So as you want to, honestly, I prefer the on option. So again, on the local data history, I prefer on, and then apply and OK, because for me, it's quite annoying that always the history is showing, but you can set it up as you prefer and want to. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you know how to use the history in input fields in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Hit the like button, add a comment and subscribe for free, and then see you in the next video.